Waking mess, money mess, thought of manga, made a puddle, bring that double, hold it double, waking mess, move that. Hey everybody, welcome to Sidekicks at Home. Today we're going to look at the first part of week one, fitness and active recovery. We're going to be doing some foam rolling, which is also known as self-myofascial release. So I have my trusty little roller here, gonna work on my calf. Remember, each body part we work for about 90 seconds. And since your calf is round, we're gonna wanna turn the toe in, hold on a position, roll to a tight spot, hold on it. If I need a little bit more pressure, I can cross my leg over the top. Now let's go and hit this outside of my lateral gastroc. Oh, that feels good. Gonna work my way up, about 1 inch per second. Again, don't use the roller like a rolling pin. Just roll till you get to a tight spot. Hold on it till you feel a release. So now we're gonna start working on our glute medius, big muscle between the hip bone, the pelvic bone. Start on the side. We can always roll our body back toward the SI joint and forward toward the hip flexor. Again, we're always gonna take as much time as we need to release the tight spots. Typically we say about 90 seconds per area. The nice thing about this position, I can turn it easily into a TFL stretch. I have to go down past the hip bone. That connects to the IT band. And as I work down toward the knee, I'm hitting the vastus lateralis, which is the quadricep, where it ties into the IT band. Take your time on this. It can be kind of sensitive. From this 90-90 position with my hips and knees, I'm going to work my lats more toward the back. Remember the three-hand position, so I'll start with the palm down. Hold for about 30 seconds. We turn the thumb to the ceiling. And you can always roll a little bit to adjust the muscle placement, and then palm up. Take some good deep breaths. Now we're going to hit the adductors. Start with the roller perpendicular to your leg at a 90 degree angle, hit where the attachment is. And as you stretch your leg up and roll away from the roller down the inside of the thigh, take your time, find all those spots, work yourself down to your knee. Again, about 90 seconds. Take good deep breaths. So the kneeling hip flexor stretch, make sure this hip is internally rotated, so you should be able to see the foot a little bit. So when you kneel down, turn that foot out. Make sure you reach above your head, squeeze your glutes and push your hips forward. And this is a great hip flexor stretch. Take good deep breaths, feel that stretch. Lean back if you can. Hold for about 30 seconds, do both sides. So this first stretch is a figure four. We use two positions. The first one, you wanna make sure you keep your base leg nice and tight and straight, your back flat on the ground. Pull your knee up and over, you'll feel the stretch here in the piriformis. Hold that for about 30 seconds. Then you'll bring this up to a figure four, pulling up on your opposite hamstring. You'll feel this more in your glute maximus. If you want to enhance your hip stretch, you can push this knee forward while you're doing it. Lay back, take good deep breaths. Don't worry about time. Think about in terms of holding your breath or breathing in deeply three to five times. This will be floor angels. Checks your external rotation of your shoulders and your lat flexibility. You want to make sure your back stays flat to the ground. Rotate your arms. Keep the back of your hands flat. And reach as far as you can up above your head, keeping your back flat. Bring it back down with your elbows. Trying to keep your hands flat to the floor. Do that 15 times. So we're going to do a neck stretch. Take your right arm behind you, pull it down with your left arm, come up nice and tall, and you're gonna lean your head away, so in this case, to the left.
really feel, you can enhance the stretch putting your neck back a little bit or bringing your chin forward. You'll feel some different spots in your neck. This feels really great after a long day sitting in front of your computer, after any type of really good strong core workout. Remember always to do both sides. Take your time, probably about 30 seconds per side.